16th, that one. That's on the 16th. Size right. Very fine thread. Something a bit more robust than that. There's a circle up there. There we go, and just a little wee circle up. I need to put wires through all these bolts as well. You'll have got to remind me. And we've got it off. Back in so it all stays together. So this is your brake lever. It's got a Woodruff key in it, so you can't go wrong. Which probably needs to be removed before we... get that off. Get it with a pair of pliers. And it doesn't want to come out. Usually fall out when you don't want them to fall out, but when you want them to fall out, they don't come out. See if it'll come out. A little lever in the back here. Yeah. I'm going to have to make a new key. I wonder if that difficult. This one's been there that long, it's not fucking out. What I think I'll do is, I'm trying to do that thing of heating it, but there's a sealer here and I don't want to put it up in there. You can shout at the screen and tell me how to get out now, that'd be handy. The problem is I can't take that shaft out because there's 11 gallons of fuel behind it, oil behind it. Maybe try heating it, keep all the heat to this side. Yeah, there I go. Cool down. Sometimes when you heat things and then they shrink past where they were when they were when they cool again. So I'm gonna wait to get a cup of tea. I'll come back down in a while. Well, I've let it all cool down and I've got it started to move. Probably have to make a new one. That's it. God knows where that went. Use a magnet or something, go over the old gap and see if we can pick it up. So, more things to do. I'll let that go. Let's see what we need. It looks like it's a squat pin in there. Just going to get a bit more light on the subject. On there. I'm going to put it in yesterday, as I say. Yeah. course, I pushed through for this side with the pins at the back just to make it more difficult to get off. Big. Seem to like sticking these odd Whitworth nuts in here for some reason. Yeah, I've got a leak from the gearbox and the PTO thing. It switches the PTO on. There's two to come out. Right, I'm going to age a couple of years before we get all the oil leaks sorted in this thing. And to a different size. 16. No, it's not. It just needs encouraged on. I do like to put bolts in bad places for. Disappearing into the lip now. I've got a 5/8 on one side and a 16mm on the other side, I think. See, when that happens when you go to do a simple job like put a brake cable on. Sorry. Not went, but I'll find it. So. Right, a bit more access now. Right, I've got to empty these butt pins out of there somehow. One thing I have got is plenty of split pins. Oh, found a nut. There's a washer there somewhere as well, we'll get it. Oh, and I found a Woodruff key, you know. Fairly big key, that one. I'm going to tidy up before I put it back. The bottom, here we go. Trying to get the bottom bit straightened. It and then you just need a punch to punch it out now. And the old punch should be there. Let's do it over here. In case you're interested, that's actually a sad lamp. Gives you plenty of light, that's why I use it. It moved. I don't think they intended it to be used as a garage workshop light. But they're not that expensive. You get a pretty good light out there. Hey, that's one light. Just need to get the pin out here. Pretty bad woods here, isn't it? I don't know. Quarters of an inch we need. I think it's 3/4 of an inch long. Engine 3/4, surely. put a socket behind it, so when I hit it that way, hopefully it'll come this way. Yep. Open the bottle. Got a bit of 16mm the size, that'd be a better idea. If you'd watched my other videos, I'd lost this and actually bought a new one, and I said, well, if I buy a new one, I'm about to find it. So what have I just done? Found it. I've got two of them now. I have used the new one. Three-eighths. Cut that with machine. When I was cutting the rod, I found this bar, so I'll see if it will run. Moved it a bit. That's hot. See if I can rotate it on the vice grips. It has come out a wee bit. moving. Where have I? Yeah, I've got it moving. Let's see if I can get some WD-40 in there. Nice and free now anyway. So I'm going to get it to come out. Soak in. The heat should pull it in like we could pull any attraction. I think this clever pin's been out here for a long, long time. Yes. Run this flush now. Keep going on it. Melted the end of my tube. Good stuff, the WD-40. Use it at work trying to get motors. When you're taking fans off of motors, if you let it penetrate in, it makes a big difference. I've got a puller. The old days we used to just get them out without a puller. Yeah, it's got to tighten. So they ended up in funny shapes. Little hammer might just be at that. Just on the flush at the back there. The back that's holding.